not able to gather for yoga at Grace, I thought that I could still share a practice with you. And this way, you can do it anytime, at home, in any space that you find, with a mat, or perhaps you're doing it on the floor if you don't have a mat, and that's totally fine. Some of you who have come to yoga at Grace will know these moves. This will be a standard kind of yoga practice today. But some of you may be doing this for the first time. So I encourage you to see where you can go with it. There is no pressure. The thing about our yoga practice, yoga in general, is that you do not have to look a certain way, contrary to popular belief. You're not meant to look a certain way or look perfect in a pose. This is about feeling the poses that we do, feeling the stretches. It is more important that you feel it in the right places, and you also feel your muscles strengthening, and then flexibility comes later. So don't worry if you find yourself, your balance is off, and also balance will differ depending on the time of the day. It's different from morning to night, so that could even affect it. So no pressure, and I can't even see you, so I don't even know what's happening on the other side. But I hope this brings just a moment in your day, a good start to your week. I find yoga is, for me, I like it best either early in the morning or in the evening to kind of settle me down. So you choose what is the best time for you, and let me know what you think if you want more of these. So today we're going to do a pretty sort of basic yoga practice with some foundational poses, so nothing too fancy. We will start with a seated meditation, and then we will go through a gentle warm-up, and then we will do some standing flows, standing exercises and some balance, and then we'll work our way gradually back down to the mat. And you can pause whenever you need to. If you need more time in a pose, or if you want to review something, you take this at your own pace. The first thing to do is to get seated comfortably at the top of the mat, if you're using a mat. And this means, for me, comfortable is cross-legged. I realize this is not the case for everybody, so if it feels more comfortable to have your legs out, or maybe you have a kind of one leg open and one leg bent and you can switch, that's completely fine. If you find that that's not working being on the floor, sit in a chair. You can do this meditation in a chair. And you can continue, in fact, the exercises in our warm-up, you can easily do in a chair. So find a space. Give yourself a big roll of the shoulders. Just roll them back and down. And let's close the eyes. Let's begin to just observe where the breath is in this moment. So I'm taking this breath as an inhale through the nose, and an exhale through the nose. Not forcing it, just letting it flow as it naturally would. Feeling the little rise and fall of the belly. Taking a moment to just acknowledge where we're at. Let's start physically. Begin to notice places in your body that are already relaxed, places that are already feeling good and loose. Maybe it's the arms. Maybe your face is starting to let go of those muscles, so letting go of frown lines, letting the cheeks relax. Even your jaw, sometimes we clench our jaws. Just let the jaw relax, let the tongue loosen inside the mouth. And notice if there's any areas in the body that you're holding tension today. This could be the upper body. It often is for a lot of people. So think about how those shoulders feel, how the neck feels. Allow the weight of the shoulders to drop back and feel the neck growing longer. Traveling down the spine to the lower back, another area that often holds tension. And maybe we might want to pull our core in. That just means pulling in the belly button slightly, and you'll feel all of a sudden your lower back feels more supported, more braced. And we'll do lots of spine stretching to help that area. Think about the hips, especially if you're sitting cross-legged. Are they starting to bother you? Are they starting to talk to you? Allow the knees to just fall away if you're sitting in this position. Feel their weight. Let the calves relax, even the ankles, and the feet, and the toes. Which areas are still speaking to you? Find a place, using the breath, inhale into that space in the body. Imagine you're filling that space up with air, energy, and as you exhale, the tension is disappearing, and that area in the body is opening up. Do this breathing technique for as long as you need to, taking each area of tension in the body, imagining breathing into it, and then releasing that exhale. We start to now observe the mind, and there's probably a lot going on there today. We're holding so much. Ask yourself if there's one thought you can let go of for this moment. Is there one thought we can just set aside? If we find there's just too many, your mind is racing, let's pretend that we are an observer and we can step outside of ourselves, outside of the mind, and just watch. Watch those thoughts. Acknowledge that they exist. Be kind. Rather than trying to reject or avoid the thoughts that enter, we accept they are a part of us. We accept they exist. And then we just let them pass through for the moment. Imagine it's a clearing that you're trying to see through this haze of busy thoughts. Slowly clearing away to get to what really is the heart center. Begin to shift your attention to the heart and allow it to tell you what it needs today. The heart often speaks more quietly than the mind. So we have to listen carefully. We have to feel its warmth radiating through the body. And it's perhaps in that heart center that maybe we find an intention for our practice, or for our day, or a week ahead. So ask yourself simply, where would you like to send your positive energy today? Maybe there's a part of your own life that needs it. Maybe you have a specific goal in mind. Or maybe there's someone else that comes to mind who needs that positivity today. You visualize that person. Devote your practice to them. And each time you come to the mat, your intention can change. It can even change throughout your practice. Perhaps it evolves. So this isn't about picking the right intention, the perfect intention, but just picking an intention that speaks to you in this moment. Since this moment is all we have. Let's bring our focus back to the breath. Begin to breathe deeply into the lower belly. Feel it expand. You can even place a hand there. Allow the breath to continue to rise up through the abdomen, up through the chest. And then slowly sink back down as we exhale. Think of your body as a balloon. The lungs expand each time. So inhale, you begin to inflate that balloon from the bottom up to the top. And then we gradually exhale, release. The air slowly out. Inhaling again deeply, expanding. Maybe taking it a little further, imagine that that breath is rising up and the collarbone's expanding this time. The neck is lengthening. And then we release just as slowly, taking the time to exhale. Inhale again deeply. this time, even the crown of the head is reaching taller because of that breath. And releasing. Feel the shoulders draw back down. Feel the weight into your sit bones, even on the mat. Visualize your intention once more. And use that deep breath now. Inhaling, breathe life into your intention. Imagine that balloon rising now up into the air. And as you exhale, you're sending it off, watching that balloon enter the world, knowing that your intention will be fulfilled. We're going to bring ourselves back into the awareness of the space that we're in. So inhale again, one more time, deeply. Then open the eyes as you exhale. And hopefully we feel a little more centered. If you need to shake out after sitting for a while, go ahead. Maybe little rotations, or maybe switch the way that you're sitting. And we'll begin a gentle warm up. Inhaling, reaching up, looking up to the hands, and exhale. And again, inhale. And release. One more time. And the next time, inhale, let's bring the hands together, interlace, and then push those palms up high. And really feel the lengthening happening. You might feel that your knees start to lift, so we want to try to relax those knees down. Inhale, press. And then exhale, bring the hands in front. We're going to round the back. So we're pulling this belly button in, almost as if it's going to meet the spine, and we're dropping the chin to the chest. Feel the shoulder blades pulling away from each other. And then on your next inhale, open wide. Pulling now shoulder blades towards each other and lifting the heart. Using the breath again. Inhale here. Exhale, round.
Just lightly touch fingers. And then inhale, open again.
We'll flow back and forth. Exhale, round.
Inhale, open,
and round.
And one more time, inhale,
and round.
Interlace the fingers again. Inhale, push all the way back up.
Hold. Inhale, press again. Exhale, and let's take one arm over into a side stretch. You may want to stay on the hand, or some of you may want to drop to the forearm to get an even deeper stretch. Again, you go where your body wants to go. Inhale, rise.
And let's exhale to the other side. The stretch feels especially good in the morning when we feel tight through the sides. Inhale. Palms together. Exhale. Down to the heart. And I wish you namaste. Namaste is a greeting.
That means the light in me honors the light in each and every one of you. So it's a good way to actually begin your practice by wishing namaste. Inhale and exhale. And we'll continue our warm-up. Couple of little small stretches. Let's first just take a twist. So take hand to opposite knee, just pick a side, and twist looking over the back shoulder. And again, these moves especially can easily be done in the chair. Twisting over to the other side. Looking back as far as we can. Releasing. Taking a fold now. Inhale. And exhale. You're just going to fold right over. Fold forward. Let your hands drop down, and you might be, with this stretch, you might be here, or you might be a little further out. This is a stretch that's a relaxing fold, so don't worry about how far you come. Just let your head hang wherever it wants to hang. And while you're in this fold, you should feel some rounding through the back, lower back relaxed. We can add a couple of side stretches here. So we're going to walk our hands over to the right side. And over to the left. Coming back to the center, inhale and rolling back up through the spine. Anytime we roll, our head is going to come up last. Let's take it to all fours now. Continue our warm up here. So we want to stack our joints, which means we have a nice long line. My shoulder is over the wrist. Knees are just under the hips. And we'll do our cat and cow. This is a really well-known yoga flow for your spine to warm it up. So we're going to inhale. And as we inhale, we're arching the back. Think of it as we're pushing the hips up, lifting the chest, but we're dropping the belly. And then exhale, opposite movement, rounding to cat. This time we're pulling that belly button back in toward the spine as much as we can. And again, inhale. Lifting for cow. Exhale, and now rounding to cat. Inhale, lift, exhale, round,
grounding. Coming to a flat back. We're going to do a little spinal balance. Starting with the right leg, taking it back. And we're going to flex that foot, which means we're keeping that 90 degree bend. See with the ankle. And we lift just to hip height. So one long line. Notice my body is in one long line. You're pushing the heel right back behind you. You can stay right here, or you can add more balance by reaching with your opposite arm, reaching forward. This is your spinal balance. You're gazing down at the mat, and that's going to keep your neck in line with the spine. You can still think about pulling the belly button in. Balance exercises are always core exercises too. And release. We'll try out the other side. Left leg, foot flexed, lift, and reach with your opposite arm when you feel ready. Fingertips are actively reaching. Heels pushing back. Breathing and release to child's pose. Child's pose is our resting pose. So it's big toes are together, knees are apart, and you sit back, relaxing. So once again, just like our forward fold earlier, our back is rounding. This is a feel-good pose. We're going to get a little more movement, a little more strengthening going on here. So we want to start to feel where our plank is today. Start with our modified plank. So you just shift forward. My shoulders are back over my wrists. And notice that I'm not here on all fours, but my hips are now in front of my knees. This is your modified plank. And let's get a little rock going. So we just shift from modified plank back to your child's pose and feel how the joints are doing today. And this is, you can move at any pace that feels comfortable to you. You can slow it down, just bend a minute of just doing this back and forth. When you're ready to add to this, and this is optional, you don't have to, but some of you might want the strengthening component, we can start to add a tricep push-up, which means we're going to lower down, elbows by our sides, and then push back to child's pose. So on this push-up, my elbows are not going out here, this is a shoulder push-up, but they're going in and brushing my sides. That way you're going to feel it in those triceps and the backs of the arms. So each time, just doing one little push-up if you like. And you'll see a little bit later also why it might be good to warm up with these. Let's do one more. Feel free to do more of any of these. You can pause the video and do more. Back to child's pose. We move into our first downward dog. So take your hands out a little bit, tuck your toes, and lift your hips. And once you're there, we're going to walk our dog. That means just pedaling the feet. That means feeling now the hamstrings pushing through each heel
most common yoga poses, but it can be very uncomfortable for some people, and it takes a while to feel where your downward dog is. So I encourage you to play with the distance. Sometimes our shoulders take too much weight, and that means you might be too far out. You might be here, and you might need to step a little closer in. Don't worry about your heels touching the mat. Not important. Do spread your fingers widely, though, to help take the weight. And let's just try and hold our downward dog. So press your heels, and whether they're touching the mat or not, just hold it. And take yourself into your first plank, high plank. You feel free to drop to your knees. And then, if you're feeling strong, though, stay on your toes. Pulling the shoulders back, creating a nice long line here. Challenging yourself to hold on to it. This is our strengthening. And lifting back to downward dog. Taking a big breath. Let's do that one more time, just holding. We're not going to do anything fancy. Just coming back to that plank and hold. Anytime with anything that we do, always feel free to drop to your knees and modify if you need to. And lift. And then let's walk or step to the top of the mat, come to your forward fold. We just let everything hang down. You can let your arms sway. You can maybe grab your elbows and let them sway. A little sway of your hips. Even your knees may be shaking out. Whatever feels good here. A little extra stretch for your shoulders after the planks. Interlace the hands behind. And then press upwards. And you might be here, just pulling back. You feel that stretch. If your shoulder flexibility is there, you can lift the arms a little higher. Just let the head hang. Shaking it out. Nodding back and forth. And release. We're going to roll up, so slowly take our time, softening the knees first, and then rolling through the spine. Again, head is going to come up last, and that helps you avoid any head rushes too. And now we're at the top of the mat. So what we're going to do next is some slow sun salutations. I'm going to talk you through it because there are a few different parts. And we'll do the first one modified. So modified again, it usually means putting our knees down, so I'll show you. And then the second one, if you want to take it further, you have that option. So we start in mountain, just feet hip distance apart on the mat, and we feel solid here. Palms are open, chest is open. Roll your shoulders back just to relax them. And let's take a big inhale together. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, lean your chest to create a nice flat back coming down to your forward fold. We're stepping the right leg back and dropping the knee. Now you can stay right here. that's not just for looks, that's for protecting your knees, otherwise you're going to compromise them. So this could be your stretch here as you press through the hips and you feel this hip flexor stretch. Or you can add on by inhale, lifting into what we call a modified crescent lunge. Releasing, stepping back to child's pose just for one big breath, quick little release. And this is what those tricep push-ups, if you did them, were getting us ready for. This is, in Sanskrit, this is called a chaturanga, or we call it a half series flow. This is where we get a lot of strengthening from. So we're gonna shift to our modified plank. And we're lowering down, just like a tricep push-up, elbows in, lowering down, maybe pausing halfway. This is called crocodile. Lower all the way down, and then lift the chest for baby cobra. Notice I'm not pressing into the hands. I want to use my back muscles and keep the tops of the feet down as well. Rounding back to child's pose. That was one, and we're going to do it one more time, since it takes a couple of times to get the hang of it anyway. Out to your modified plank, lowering down halfway, pausing, drop all the way down, lift for baby cobra, and round back to child's pose. We're taking now the right foot, the same leg that stepped back, is now going to step forward. So we're lunging now on the other side. Again, check out your lunge, knee over the ankle, make any adjustments, and inhale, rise to that crescent lunge. Big breath. Release. Let's tuck the back toes, lift that back knee, step forward, or make your way in any way feels comfortable. Back to your forward fold. Into a half lift, which means we just create a flat back now. Shoulders back. Back to forward fold. Now we're going to end with a chair pose. Chair pose is like a squat. So we want to bend the knees first to safely come up. Inhale, sweep up with the arms, and exhale, sit back into your chair squat. The weight is in the heels, so your toes, you can wiggle them, they should be relaxed. And let's go into another salutation. Inhale, exhale, forward fold. This time, left foot is stepping back first. And we can drop the knee again, doing the same thing we did before. Or, if you're feeling good here, feeling strong, maybe stay here and rise to your crescent lunge. This is going to give you much more strengthening and also a lot of balance. So, if you find yourself wavering, completely normal. This is a tough balance. Releasing to downward dog, or your option is child's pose. Taking a big breath, we're going to flow again through that half series. So if you need to drop your knees, by all means, go for it. If you feel strong, we're going to shift to our plank. Lower you down halfway, elbows in by your sides for crocodile. Now we're flipping the tops of the feet, pushing them into the mat, and we're lifting. Now we're pushing into the hands for upward facing dog. Coming back to downward dog. I'm going to do that one more time. yourself in your upward dog eventually to see if you can only have your feet and your hands pressing into the mat. So I'll show you again. Plank. Halfway crocodile. A little bit lower. And then lift.
So see how my legs are not touching the mat, just my feet and my hands are.
Coming back to downward dog. And now the left foot is going to step forward. And you can drop that back knee and rise with the arms, or you can challenge yourself even more, rise here. Crescent lunge on the other side. Evening out our balance here. And release, step forward. Forward fold. Half lift. And just trying to create a flat back and long neck. Forward fold. And up into a chair. Soft knees. Inhale, rise. And exhale. Here we are back in our squat. Relaxing the toes. Inhale, rise. And then just let this breath go. So, well done. Congratulations. You just completed maybe what was your first sun salutations. And please watch that segment over. Do them as many times as you would like to get the hang of them, because that's a sort of standard flow that you will always see, or you'll see some variation of in most yoga practices. We're going to move on to some warriors, some pretty common yoga poses, standing poses. This is going to be mostly about strengthening through the lower body. All of these use the core though, so there are going to be moments where you're going to be engaging the core and pulling it in. We're going to start with warrior one. We're going to step back with the right foot. Take a step. So this time, your foot is all the way down into the mat. So it's not where we were before, so you don't want your heel lifted. You want the heel pressing down. So it might not be as wide as where we were earlier. Nice square hips, so they are facing forward. You can twist, make sure it gets there. Little lunge in that front knee. And inhale, lift the arms, and we're in warrior one. So warrior one is what's known as a gentle warrior. Mostly what we're feeling is if we're pressing through that back heel, we should feel a calf stretch. And then we should feel a little bit of strengthening happening in that front quad or that front thigh. From warrior one, we're going to open to warrior two. So notice that when I opened from here, I didn't move my legs. I just rotated my body. You don't need to move this left leg here that's bent into the lunge. You may need to, though, move your right leg further back to widen your stance, because warrior two is known as our strong warrior. It is a deeper lunge. We pay attention again to the knee being no further than the ankle. A good point of reference is to gaze down and see, do you still see your big toe past the knee? If the toe disappears completely, then we need to pull back on our lunge or maybe widen the legs. Arms are out long, and we're gazing over that front arm to the same direction you're lunging in. We're gazing. Pulling in the belly button. And from warrior two, we go into reverse warrior. Reaching forward,
first warrior, back to warrior two. Letting go of that lunge, we take our triangle. This is all about lengthening now. So we're going to send our hips back, just push them behind you there. Reach through that front arm till we have nowhere left to go, and let that hand drop down anywhere on the leg. So the key here, what we're looking for, is not how far down you can reach. You may be here, but you're looking for this line where the shoulders are in one line and the arms are in a line. So if you find that this is happening, and you're out, you're kind of rounding the back and looking down at the mat, then all you have to do is lift this hand a little higher up on the leg, and that's really going to help you keep the chest open, keep everything in a nice line, keep the back flat too. If you can keep that chest open, then you start to lower the hand down. Pushing through the feet, inhale, rise. We're going to make our way back to the top of the mat so you can heel toe that right foot until you can step forward. Back to your mountain. I'm just going to do that same short segment on the other side. And I'm actually going to step this way. So you can still see me, I won't have my back to you. So from our mountain, this time it is the left foot that's stepping back. And we are lunging, we're keeping our hips square again. Pressing into that back heel, inhale, lift. And sometimes something that some people like to do is bring their hands together and maybe reach behind them, add a tiny back bend. This is optional, so especially if your lower back does not feel good with back bends, do not worry about that. Just keep reaching upwards. Opening up to warrior two. Now again, just turn the hips open, turn the body open. Begin to walk your left foot back. And that way we can get a deeper lunge. We check out that front knee. Do we still see the toes? And we do. Sometimes this back arm as well wants to drop down. It gets tired. So take a look back there and lift it so it's still shoulder height. Gazing over that front arm. Staying strong. Moving into reverse warrior, reach forward, flip the palm, reach back. If you wrapped your bottom arm on the other side, go ahead and wrap it here. Inhale, back to that warrior two, and then release your lunge. That gives you a little extra challenge there of having to hold that lunge a bit longer. Into triangle, push the hips back, reach, and let the hand float down. Remember, it can be anywhere on the leg, so you can maybe start higher. See if you can stay open. A nice image here is thinking about that your back is flat against a wall. So can it stay flat as you lower the hand? If it can't, don't worry about reaching further down. Either we're looking straight ahead or you can look up towards that hand. And we're pushing through the feet. Inhale, rise. Taking the hands to the hips. This time, one more stretch. We're adding an extra one on this side, which is a wide forward fold. So we're going to pigeon toe the feet, which as a reminder, that means your toes are going inwards, not outwards, but slightly inwards. And we're going to fold forward here. So with the breath, inhale and exhale, lead with your chest. Help keep that flat back. Let your hands drop down. So the key about the stretch, this is not about flexibility. It's not about how far your head can go and if it can reach the mat. But it's all about the stretch, because you should be feeling the stretch through here, through the hips, back here, and through the backs of the legs and the hamstrings. So you just come hang in a place that allows your upper body to relax. You might find that you do have a little extra room. You can widen your legs if you feel that you have a little more flexibility to play with. And if your head does come close to the mat or is on the mat, then you can maybe grab onto the outsides of the feet or the ankles or the heels. It's going to sound a little strange, but what you want to imagine here is that you are lifting your hips up to the ceiling. So as you press into the feet, you feel as though you're lifting upwards through those large lower body muscles, and then you'll feel even more of a stretch through the glutes. It's not a move that you'll see, but you'll definitely feel the muscles opening and stretching. Staying here for as long as you like. And then we are going to slowly come out of it by coming up halfway and walking our hands. I'm going to go back in the original direction I was in before, but walking your hands back to whatever your top of the mat is and stepping forward into your forward folds, your regular forward fold here. Give yourself a little sway. Just relax, shake out the knees. And let's come up with a big breath this time. So softening the knees, inhale, sweep up. And exhale. All right, we're going to try a little balance before we start to wind our practice down. So for our balance today, we're going to do tree pose because it's a very standard yoga balance. One of the first ones, I think, that you learn when you start a yoga practice, so we're going to do it together today. So for tree, sometimes coming off of the mat is a little more stable, especially if you're on a hardwood floor. I kind of like the feel of the floor. If you're on carpet, I would definitely come off of a mat if you're using a mat on carpet, because that will feel a little more stable. So we're going to start balancing into our right side first. So feel that weight in your right. Your right side, feel all corners of the feet. Hands maybe to the hips for some stability, and maybe then starting to open your left hip. This might be your balance right here. You're just lightly placing your toes down if you're afraid of falling, or please feel free to hold on to something. If you have a chair, then you'll have it on this right side. You can hold on to it. If you feel a little more steady, then maybe you're lifting that foot, and it can come to the ankle or anywhere on the leg, as long as it's not pressing into the knee, because we want to avoid the knee pressing into the joints is never good. When you are ready, palms to prayer. And then maybe opening up all the way to your full tree. Something that helps your balance if you really find yourself wavering and falling out is to find a fixed point on the floor just a few feet in front of you and gaze at that point. Because if your gaze is fixed, it's going to be easier for your body to follow. Coming slowly out of it, palms together, come out the same way we came in. So let's try to be intentional about the way we come out rather than rushing out of it. And then releasing the leg back to the center. Big breath, inhale. And let it go. Let's try the other side. So this time, now stepping into the left foot, centering the weight. Finding that fixed point on the floor to help your balance and opening up that right hip. Either staying here until you're ready to lift that foot, taking baby steps. That's another thing about balance is we never want to rush it. Take the foot where it wants to go and bring the palms to prayer. And if you fall out of it, the key is to start over again from the beginning. So rather than trying to just come back in where you fell out, take your time to go through the steps again. Inhale, opening up if you feel good with your balance. Maybe lifting your gaze as an extra challenge, as if you feel steady. Lifting upwards, looking at the ceiling. And slowly coming back in, or back out, rather the same way we came in. Palms back down, and then we're going to release the leg. Back down. Inhale, and let it go. Balance is always difficult. So I know most people come into a yoga class and say, oh, my balance is all over the place, it's terrible. Well, that's why we do this. You're not expected to have perfect balance right away. So we're going to keep working on balance. If there are more videos to come, then we'll do some different balance poses with them. We're going to start to wind ourselves down. So we're going to go back to the top of the mat. So where you were at the top of your mat, you don't need to move probably. And take one more forward fold together. Inhale. Exhale. And from here, step back to a downward dog. This is the last time. Right foot back, left foot back. Maybe walking out your dog one final time. And it should feel different now. Hopefully, your legs feel warmer. And this feels a little easier pedaling through. Holding that downward dog and pressing through the heels. Big breath. Inhale. Exhale, press through those heels and slowly begin to drop the knees. Find your child's pose, just relax.
just take some deep stretches as we get closer to our Shavasana, our relaxation. So let's take our hands now, walk them over to the right side, reaching that left arm away from you. So feel a stretch through the shoulders. And over to the other side. And right arm reaching. Back to the center. Up to all fours. And let's just sit down to one side so we can swing the legs around and take a seated forward fold. So we start in our staff pose. Our staff pose is just sitting here, legs outstretched, feet flexed, shoulders back, sitting nice and tall. And then from staff pose, taking a breath again, inhale and exhale, fold forward. And just let your hands relax anywhere on the legs. Let your head drop down. So again, you might be here, and that's completely fine. You just let your shoulders relax and let your head relax. If you are out a little further, maybe you can reach the feet or the big toes. And just take a couple of deep breaths here. One breathing technique you can try is a sinking breath. With a sinking breath, we inhale, lift slightly, and then exhale, see if we can fold a little deeper. Inhale, lifting, and exhale, sinking. Inhale, lifting. Exhale, sinking. Inhale and exhale, and then just hold it here. And slowly start to roll yourself back up. We're going to bend the knees, grab behind the legs, and roll yourself safely down to the mat. Bringing the knees into the chest, give them a big hug, and just rock side to side. Something that can feel good is taking your hands on your knees and just circling them in one direction, and that way you feel your lower back massaging on the mat. So try that in reverse directions. And we're going to take just a couple of relaxing twists as our final stretches. So go ahead and lift those legs to, this is what we call tabletop. It's just a 90 degree bend in the legs, opening the arms wide. And then begin to drop those knees to one side, all the way down. As you turn your head to the other direction, if you want even more of a twist, maybe you're extending your top leg out, but just letting it drop down. Sometimes we are holding it up the whole time without realizing it, so let the weight of it just relax. We are surrendering to these final stretches. We're observing our breath grow deeper, back to where we started. You can spend as long as you like on each side here. I'm going to slowly shift to the other side, so knees together, lifting. And feeling that weight shift from one hip to the other. Turning the head over that opposite arm. That way it helps you keep the shoulders grounded. And if the shoulders are open and grounded, the chest is open, it's helping us with this twist. Maybe extending that top leg. Bringing knees together, lift back to the center, allow the feet to drop to the mat, and then allow now to open to butterfly, so soles of the feet together and knees opening, just letting the natural body weight open up those hips. And this is our final stretch. So you can decide how long you'd like to stay in butterfly. Also, feel free to do any other stretches that your body might be asking for while you're down here. If this is a comfortable position right here, you can stay here for your shavasana. So shavasana is our final relaxation. We're going to spend a few minutes rewarding our bodies and our minds with recovery and renewal. The key is not to skip this part. So you might be tempted to pause or stop the video. Please, I encourage you to stay with this. And this little bit of time is going to make all the difference for your practice and for the rest of your day. So moving into any comfortable position on your back that works for you. Closing the eyes. And just letting your body melt away into the mat. All those muscles and joints we have worked and stretched, completely releasing into the mat. As you stay in this deep state of relaxation, perhaps your mind is wandering back to your intention. Set one for today. Perhaps you take a moment to reflect on gratitude. I'm going to read a few words. And then feel free to stay in the state for the next few moments as I also play some music to finish our practice. Lie down for a while today in a quiet place.
sees your emotional state, your spiritual struggles, your physical fatigue. God sees your desires and your fears. You don't have to think anything or say anything. Simply allow divine love to hover over your life. Begin to slowly wiggle those toes, wiggle those fingers, and gradually bring awareness back to the body. Let the movement travel through the body. If you're still lying down, swaying the knees, swaying the feet, gently turning the head. Take your time to come out of this deep, relaxed state. Take a moment to bend the knees and roll to one side to reconnect mind to body. When you feel ready, come to the top of the mat. That comfortable seated position that you began your practice with. We will finish with three big breaths together. Inhaling into our first one. Exhaling to the heart. Breathing even more deeply, releasing more slowly. And our final deepest breath of gratitude. Thank you so much for joining me. I am grateful for all of you today and every day. And I wish you a peaceful rest of the day or rest of your week. Peace be with you. Mm-hmm.